question.
Oh, one more night before Santa slides down that chimney. And we start with a premier AA matchup in Saco. Who would be getting the big present or a lump of coal? And if you wondered if South Portland would be challenged, they would be. TA hosting the Red Riots, Alicia Marcus the putback. Trojans up 6 in the second. Other way, JP Estrella, the 3. He had 16, Red Riots up 1 at the break. But here comes Braden Kamari. The 3 for TA, ties it at 50. Then Kamari, another bomb. Trojans up 3 with 3 to play. Red Riots battle back. Nolan Hobbs with a little baby hook inside. Then Owen Maloney gets it on the wing. He goes to work. He had 18, 57-53. South Portland wins on the road. Festive Westbrook student section today watching the Blue Blazes host Kennebunk. Aiden Taylor gets to the paint for Westbrook, and Westbrook has a 27-26 lead in the second quarter. But the Rams close the half on a run. Connor Keefe drives and dishes to Joseph Kazulis. He had 14. Then off the miss, Keegan Andrews. Oh, that's what friends are for. 73-59. Kennebunk the win. Gorham and Scarborough going at it. Rams up in the fourth. Elijah Wyatt to Jackson Smith. They extend the lead to 11. Then Gabe Michaud cuts down the middle, gets the bucket. He had 16 for the Rams. Other way, Rowan McDonald showing off his dribble moves, but Gorham would get the road win 50-42. AA North matchup, Wyndham hosting Edward Little. Eagles pounding it inside early. Nick Garrison seals, and the nice finish, he had 12. For EL, Marshall Adams left alone. He takes care of business. He had a dozen as well. Hey, 12 is the number to have today. John Shea cutting inside. He had 12. Edward Little, 63-31, the road win. All right, big crowd for a rivalry game. Portland and Deering. Bulldogs up 4 late, and they would seal it at the line. James Johnson and Brady Toer both sink free throws. And Portland, big week for them. They beat Cheverus and Deering on the road this week, 45-40 in this one. All right, Biddeford boys hosting Marshwood in a back-and-forth game in Biddeford. Tigers trailed at the half, but opened the third on a run. Will Goodwin gets the friendly roll. He had 11. Then Kyle Benson from the other corner. Biddeford goes up 9. But Marshwood does not go away. Aiden Sullivan, he can score anywhere. Knocks it down. He had 19. Then Alex and Sarah, the nice bounce pass to Cooper Aguiar. Hawks end the game on a 23-5 run and win it 46-37. Elgin Visig has Lewiston playing some good ball, hosting Cheverus. Yusuf Duquesne to the hoop for 2. Blue Devils up 6 late. Cheverus makes some play on defense, though. Giovanni St. Onge to Leo McNabb for the basket, and they're still in it. But Lewiston, the clever inbounds play. Donovan Jackson to Elijah Bigelow, 60-48. The Blue Devils have won back-to-back games. Falmouth and Brunswick, Navigators come out hot. Brady Coyne from distance, he had 25. This is all about three guys. Coyne had 25. Jack Stoll, he had 29. The nice change of hands. Judd Armstrong had 21. So those guys combined for 75. Falmouth, 93-55 over Brunswick. All right, Coney and Brewer, battle of 4-0 teams up in Brewer. And the Brewer Witch Project can shoot. Aaron Newcomb from downtown. For the Rams, Cam Dewan, he counters the nice Euro for 2. But as I said, this team can shoot. Brady Saunders drains the 3. Brewer all over Coney, 90-60 to hand them their first loss. Miranda Cook hosting MCI. Black Bears in control in the second half. Tyler Rabin running to Braden St. Pierre, the rainbow from the baseline. Then Rabin working the offensive glass. Check out this putback, holding off a defender in midair. 69-41, Miranda Cook, their first win. All right, Bangor leading Morris 39-19 at the half, and the Rams continuing to roll in the third. Colton Emerson feeds Max Clark on the block. Bulldogs, Matthew Trombley displaying his driving ability. Bangor can't stop him, but the Rams get the win 71-49. On the girls' side, Thornton Academy looked strong during the pandemic season a year ago. With a full roster returning, they've picked up right where they left off. Tonight, traveling to South Portland to take on the Red Riots. Hot shooting first quarter, Hannah Cook for 3. She had 10 for the Golden Trojans. Anna Brown counters a 3 for South Portland. She had 14. Then Addison Sulikowski, the 3 for the Trojans. She had 22. Back and forth we go. Emma Travis answers at the other end with a 3 for the Red Riots. But Jessica Dow was unstoppable. The hoop and the foul, she had 20. 68-61. Thornton Academy is unbeaten. Marshwood girls looking for their first win of the season, taking on Biddeford. Second quarter, Chantel Bouchard inside for Biddeford. She led the way for the the Tigers with 8. Other way, Shelby Anderson with a one-handed pass to Mia Konstantakos for 3. She had 13 leading the way. Then Savannah Nashwinter spots up for the 3. 8 of her 10 came in the second quarter, and Marshwood gets the win 46-28. Unbeaten Gorham hosting Scarborough. First quarter, Briley Bishop doing what she does, making shots. She had 10 for the Rams. Scarborough with the pressure. Emerson Flaker with the steal and the lay-in. Red Storm by 3 after 1. All Rams from there, though. Nicole Walker spots up, knocks it down. Then on the break, Walker ahead to Anna Nelson, that is, who had 19. 40-26, Gorham with the victory. All right, city rivalry, Portland hosting Deering. Rams outrunning Ella McGowan to Maya Gale on the break. Deering would cut the deficit to 2. On a 3 by Gale a little later, but Portland counters. Eliza Stein from downtown for 3. Part of a 14-0 run to end the third. Bellaria Yuga, check out the sweet Euro step. 47-44, Portland wins their first victory. Edward Little girls hosting Wyndham. Erin Cowie, the nice drive for Edward Little. She led the way for the Eddies with 11. Other way, Carly Morey, the corner 3. She had 10. And then Sarah Tallon pulls up. Fills it up. She led the way with 23, 44, 38. Wyndham with the road win. Lewiston girls hosting unbeaten Chevres. Stags working it inside. Emma Lizzo, good position. Not going to stop her down there. Then Lizzo showing off some of the post moves. She had a game high 18 for the Stags. Other way, Lewiston going outside. Ellie Laguerre knocking down the triple. Then in transition, Laguerre. 2 more, she had 13, but the Stags hold on. Lewiston made a game of it, 44-42. All right, let's go to the Mountain Valley Conference. Oak Hill girls hosting Monmouth Academy. Third quarter, Paige Gagne, baseline jumper, count it. Oak Hill up 13. Other way, Holly Hunt pulls up, hits the jumper from the wing, but Oak Hill would hold on. Emily Dillman driving for the hoop and the foul. Nifty move. 45-38, Oak Hill the win. That right there, Hoops 8. You can check it out again on WMTW.com. Have a happy holiday. More Total Coverage is back after this.